round of applause as well. Welcome to the stage, Fanny Cry. Great voice. It's a wonderful Mr. Steve Terry. Come on, Steve. Give him a big round of applause. Steve Terry.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be with you. Let's have some fun with some new equipment. Come on.
Dragon was a kid on board. We gonna ride till there ain't no more to go. We're taking it slow. And baby, don't you know, we'll not have real time with a pointless lady. We're hitching on a twilight train. Ain't nothing here that I care to take along. We'll need me a song, just to sing when I want. No need to say please to no man for a happy tune.
Okay, let me see if I'll get you sing, everybody. Come on now.
Oh, I love my rosy child. She's got the way to make me happy. You and me, we go in style. Crackling Rose, you're a store-bought woman. You make me sing like a guitar woman. So hang on to me, girl, our song keeps going on. My baby, cracking words, he make me smile. We're gonna move out the next one. And if it lasts for an hour, well, that's alright. Cause we've got all night just to set the world right. To find us a dream that don't ask no questions. Yeah,
I hope everybody here at Roma. Tucker said, oh, it's a big, these people love it to a frenzy. So we are gonna sing, ladies and gentlemen, the biggest song ever by Neil Diamond now. It's called Sweet Caroline. I can't see you out in the dark, so I'm gonna rely on you here and sing it nice and loud. We'll do the chorus together and wave our arms in the air. Come on.
Where it began, well, I can't begin to know when, but then I know it's growing strong.
Okay, it's the chorus from the nature.
It was in the spring, and then spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along?
Let's see if we can get some arms in the air. Okay, here we go. Come on, join in.
Hands.
Come on, you can do it for me.
Touching hands.
We're gonna sing the chorus together.
Reaching out.
Come on for the robots. Let's see your arms.
Touching me. Are you ready now? Touching you. And everybody sing Sweet Caroline.
Go.
Good times never seem so good. Look at the night, I said,
shake it, get the blood flowing.
And it don't seem so lonely, cause we fill it up with only two.
Okay, start getting ready, please, nice and low.
And when I hurt, oh, the hurting runs off my shoulders. How can I hurt when I'm holding you?
Okay, every pair of arms is tight. Come on, here we go, everybody.
Hands.
Come on, you can do it for me.
Touching hands.
You're gonna sing the chorus on your own.
Reaching out.
I wanna hear everybody singing tonight.
Touching me. Are you ready now? Touching you. And everybody sing.
Thank you very much for making me feel so welcome. Oh, hello, good evening, Cromer.
Yeah.
It's it's my first time here with you, and can I say, it's just been a lovely time. Apart from the weather, it's been a bit breezy today, a bit cold, but I'm used to it. I come from a little place called Herne Bay, down in Kent. Hooray, Herne Bay. I don't know. 4.5 hours it took me to get here today. 4.5 hours. So it's lovely. And as Tucker said, I did meet him on a cruise, actually, which I'll tell you about in a moment, but it's so lovely to hear you sing along. I want to keep you in good voice. I want to keep you in sing-along mood. So here we go. Let's try another one. Ready? I'll be loving you
always
with a love that's true
always
when the things you plan need a helping hand. I will understand
always.
Beautiful, beautiful. Here's one. Brown girl in the ring.
Cha-la-la-la.
There's a brown girl in the ring.
Cha-la-la-la.
Brown girl in the ring.
Cha-la-la-la.
And she looks like a sugar in a plum. Lovely plums. Plums, dear. Okay, but I can hear the ladies singing. It's gentlemen are usually a bit shy, okay? So we're just going to do the fellas on their own. Fellas, it's your chance to shine, okay? I'm going to give you a chance now. Just the men, just the fellas. Only magic. To be honest, I normally do that, and we get one person, basically. So, Lenger, it's a pleasure to be here. As Tucker said, I met him a few years back, actually, on a cruise, and I've just come back from the same sort of cruise, from Norway, went to the Norwegian fjords, a beautiful place, and we passed Great Yarmouth and Cromer last Thursday. It was gale force 8 out in the North Sea. It was windy last Thursday, wasn't it? Up and down we were going. I went to Amsterdam. Have you been to Amsterdam?
Yeah.
A beautiful place, lovely people on bikes. All the smells, you go past, oh, I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to find their bikes, let alone ride them. I was walking past all the, because obviously what I do when I'm away from home, I try and find Wi-Fi so I can get emails and I can contact my lovely wife who's at home with the children. And I just went around starving all day long because they go in and out of these different bars trying to find Wi-Fi and they're all smoking because it's all legal over there. You just end up getting very hungry. And I was in this place, it's true, I just feel hungry all the time. I'm not into that, but, and I was in this bar, and I said to the bar, and I said, I thought I'd treat myself, because, you know, have a look around, and a bit of shopping. And I said to the bar, I said, how much is a pint of lager? He said, it's €1. I thought, that's cheap. I said, do anything to eat? He said, yeah, we do steak, chips, and mushrooms, peas, onions. I said, lovely, how much is that? He said, €1. I said, all that food and a pint of lager for €2. I said, how do you make a profit? He said, oh, it's not my bar. I said, where's the owner? He said, he's upstairs in bed with my wife. I said, what's he doing upstairs in bed with your wife? He said, same thing as I'm doing down here to his business. If you get that, pass it down, not one gets that. And I didn't realise, and I said, can you get me a double? He brought this bloke out, looked exactly like me. I like that one, thanks, Tony. I didn't realise, I don't know, because I was concentrating trying to get Wi-Fi. It turned out to be a gay bar. I didn't know it was. And I said to this fellow I was dancing with, I said, I'm getting out of here. He said, you can't, we're in the final. I just thought, it's true. This is all true. And we went to Norway, beautiful Norway and the fjords. And some of you have been to Norway, very expensive. Compared to England, Norway is very expensive. And I got some money out to get some, I always get a gift to my children. And the only thing I could get out of the cash point was 200 kroner, Norwegian kroner they use over here. 200 kroner notes, that's all I could get. Very expensive. Went into a supermarket, I got a can of Coke and a Mars bar. I went to the cashier, I said, I've only got a 200 kroner note. She said, that's all right, put the Mars bar back. I thought, that's good. And I walked past this big fence. It was about 10 foot high. I walked past and I could hear all these people on the other side. And all these people were shouting out, 15, 15, 15. I thought, what's going on there? There's a little hole in the fence. I looked through it, somebody poked me in the eye with a stick. I went, 16, 16. I went to another playing at a cafe in Norway, and I said, I'm really hungry, we've got anything to eat. He said, our special, I think it's Norwegian, that can't be this. He said, our special is a banjo sandwich. I said, no, what? He said, a banjo sandwich. I said, what's a banjo sandwich? He said, it's a long French baguette stick. 3 fried eggs, 5 kroner. I thought, that's brilliant. I said, I'd have a banjo sandwich. He cooked it, 3 lovely fried eggs and a long French baguette stick. I said, why do you call it a banjo sandwich? He said, you will see. I took one bite, all the fried egg went right down the front of my shirt. I went, oh, no! I got Wi-Fi, phoned the wife. She said, do you want the good news or the bad news about the new car? I said, what's the good news? She said, the airbags work. I'm about to buy a new car, love. The old car, so I've changed that clutch 5 times. She said, don't blame me, I never use the clutch. She said, now, ladies, you are the best drivers. It's a proven fact, I'm not disputing that. You are the better drivers, okay? We're too aggressive, us men. Ladies are the best drivers, but unfortunately, there is one exception, and my lovely wife is that exception. We went to a Christmas party last December. It was her work to do. I said, well, love, I said, you have a couple of glasses of wine. I said, I'll be the driver. I'll drive. She said, okay. Went to the party. Lovely music, party, lot of dancing. I was on the Coca-Cola's. Driving about 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm on the motorway. It's, you know, December, sleety, snowy. I'm overtaking this lorry. She winds down the window, freaking cold. Started shouting at the driver of the lorry. She said, you're losing your load, you're losing your load. I said, he's gritting. She's useless, she is. She's useless. She's banjos. But she's in a good mood. I said, I phoned her. She said, I'm in a good mood. I said, why in a good mood? I said, I'll finish my jigsaw puzzle. I said, how long's it taking? She said, 6 months. I said, how many pieces? She said, 25. I said, it's 25 pieces. It's taking you 6 months to complete it, and you're happy about that, are you? She said, yeah, because on the box it says 2 to 3 years. We were laying in bed the other week. I'm laying in bed, 2 o'clock in the morning. It was raining hard outside. It was 2 o'clock in the morning. Knock at our front door. She said, go down, see who it is. I said, no, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. I said, it's freezing cold outside, it's raining now, and I'll get soaking, I'll catch pneumonia. I said, no, I'm not going. She said, go down, see who it is, might be someone who needs help. I said, all right then, put the dressing room. Open the front door, there's a bloke there, it's even on the rain. I said, what do you want? He said, can you give me a push? I said, no, and I slammed the door on his face, back to bed. She said, who was it? I said, it's some bloke wants a push. She said, oh, go, no, him. I said, no, it's raining, it's soaking wet. I don't know, I'm not doing it. She said, go and help me, be a good Samaritan. I said, all right. Dressing gown, I'm downstairs, up the front door, went out. I said, where are you then? He said, I'm over here on the swing. We've been together a very long time, me and my wife, and she was my first love. She was my first love. She was the first, she wasn't the first person I ever. Thank you, madam. The first time, could I say anything? I don't know, I'm the first time here. The first time I ever had sex. Frightened the life out of me. I was on my own. But I met this girl and I thought, I'll take her home to meet my mum. And I took her two friends because I wanted my mum to guess which one was the girlfriend. I took two of her friends as well. Went into my house, my mum's house. Mum's in the kitchen. I said, Mum, come in the front room, please. I sat the three girls on the settee. I said, Mum, one of these girls is my new girlfriend. Can you guess which one it is? She had a look. She said, one in the middle. I said, that's right. How can you tell? She said, I don't like her. That's right. That's true. But we went out courting, me and my wife and girlfriend then. We went. I took her up to my granddad's allotment. It's the granddad's allotment, and in my granddad's shed on the allotment with the door locked. Having a kiss and a cuddle, she said, do something naughty. So I stole the cabbage. She said to me, when I first, she said, right, come round tonight. She said, my mum and dad are going to the pictures. We'll have the whole house to ourselves. She's been after me going out for about a year. She said, come around tonight and we'll further our relationship. She said, before you come round, go down to the chemist. Get some protection. You want to do it properly. I said, okay. I went down to the chemist. It's a manservant. I said, can I buy some of them? I said, I'd like to buy some protection, please, you know. Protection. Packet things. He said, sir, he was very nice. Sir, the young man, he said, is it going to be a lucky night tonight? I said, I hope so. He got on, went home, got dressed, dabbed the old blue Stratos. Went down her house, knocked on her door. My dad answered. He said, come in, he's just getting ready. Sat in the settee with mum and dad. She came down. I said, we're going to the pictures with your mum and dad. She said, I never knew that. I said, I know, and I never knew your dad was a chemist. Before I go, sometimes you get asked to do other things, and I went to a looking at the campsite last year, and I've got a friend who's ex-manager there, and I went in the afternoon to catch up with him. I haven't seen him for a long time. I'm doing the cabaret at night time. And he said, Steve, he said, do you mind helping us out? He said, we're having a beauty competition. They still do one at the campsite, so they're lovely legs in this beauty competition. He said, one of the judges has gone sick, would you mind helping out? And I said, of course you will, no problem at all. Just before we start the competition, contestant number one came over to me. He said, Steve, if you let me win, I'll give you a kiss on the cheek. I thought, 10 minutes later, number two came over. So if you let me win, I'll give you a kiss on the cheek and a big cuddle. I thought, oh. 10 minutes later, number three came over. So Steve, if you let me win, I'll give you a kiss on the cheek, a big cuddle, let you squeeze my bottle. I thought, oh. Number four came over. So Steve, if you let me win, I'll give you a kiss on the cheek, big cuddle, let you squeeze my bottle, and I'll flash you my boobies. Number 16 won it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for me to go. It has been an absolute pleasure to join you and join Tucker up here. And of course, the gramophone is beautiful. Weren't they lovely? The harmonies were fantastic, weren't they? It's been a pleasure. Thank you for making my first visit here at the Chroma a fantastic one. I hope you enjoyed my part. Thank you very much. It's great to have you. Steve, I've been here many, many times. You said he just loved you up here, and he was absolutely right. You've made me feel very welcome. I'd like to finish now on two of my favourite songs. The first one by Shirley Bassey, and the second one by Mr. Tom Jones. Myself, Steve Terry, enjoy the rest of your night. Here we go with this. In other words, cinema. Okay. I will love you as I love you all my life. Every moment spent with you makes me more content with you, just as you are. You are all
until the moon deserts the skies, till all the seas run dry. Till then I'll worship you. Tropic sun grows cold, till this young world grows old. My darling, I'll adore you. You and then you go have a break, right? Come back and prepare yourself.
yourself a more massive entrance. So we do this thing.
Let's finish on some sunshine.
Come on then, let's do that. Sunshine in Crumber. You've never been here before, have you?
You know the words, come on, here we go.
Bring me sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can get ready in this brand new bright tomorrow.
Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears.
Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me.